Just 70 kilometres south of Perth lies the picturesque city of Mandurah, the fastest growing city in Australia. With its pristine waterways and warm Mediterranean climate, Mandurah has gone from a sleepy fishing village favoured by retirees to one of the most desirable postcodes in Western Australia. The premier event in the region is the annual Mandurah Crab Fest, but this year it coincides with the Ayers Action Sports Games, showcasing Generation Y sports like freestyle motocross, BMX and skate. But the headline act was the first ever staging in Australia of an International Water Ski and Wakeboard Federation World Cup.
So far, we have completed 33 successful stops. Coming to Mandurah, we didn't know what to expect. We've come from China, we've come from Malaysia. All are different, but Mandurah was a very special character all of its own.
With more than 60 competitors from 23 different nations taking part, it was a spectacle like none other for the 80,000 residents of this coastal city. The IWWF has a commitment to continue in Mandurah for at least 4 years, something that pleases the competitors.
One thing about wakeboarding professionally is all the travel and the amazing places you get to go. And this is my third time to Western Australia, my first time to Mandurah, and it's seriously, I mean, it's a paradise.
The water is crystal clear. We've had dolphins popping up everywhere, and it's a good vibe going around.
Yeah, it's just great weather. It's like super warm every day, awesome conditions out here, and you know, got a Mastercraft to ride behind, so it's great.
Now we've got three events involved here: wakeboard, shortboard, and jumps. Wakeboard is a little like surfing. It's a long board. You got 2 foot holes in it, and basically it's gymnastics out in the water. It's called wakeboard because you're using the wake. The boat creates a massive wake, and the riders train on these wakes so they know that they can get the lift off the wake and then perform their rotations in the air. When we move on to shortboard, just imagine we got a saw and we cut the front end and the back end off the wakeboard and you end up with a little stubby thing. Where in wakeboard, you've got a long space to develop your routines in. In a shortboard, you've got 2 20-second passes. The athletes will perform up to 18 tricks in each one of these 20-second passes, and they will include tricks held where the rope is held in your hand or locked to your foot. Last one is jumping. These jumpers will hit the base of the ramp at 100 plus kilometers per hour. In the air, if you're not absolutely fainting at that time from the G-forces, you have to decide to push down your feet so you get this extra glide in the air. And then you're flying well over 60 meters. In fact, the world record is held by Freddy, the Nightmare Kruger, at 75.2 meters. That's jumping, that's shortboard, and that's wakeboard. And that's the World Cup. We'll be right back.